promise.
Say amen.
God.
God has spoken.
So let the church.
Let the church.
Say.
Say.
Well, good evening and welcome to Shine a Light. Indoors this week, a bit windy outside, but do you know something? It's the storms of life that we have to weather. And there are times when we don't seek retreat, but we seek time to recharge our batteries. And tonight with Shine a Light, welcome. It's Bishop Desmond, Vision Temple of Praise. We had a wonderful time in church today, and we give God thanks for that. And now tonight, as we shine a light, as we shine a light to close off the week which has gone by and focus upon the week ahead. But we can't really not do that without looking at what's happening around us. The news today that a man was run down by a car and someone stabbed in the Handsworth area, potentially in the Handsworth area. We know that the person was run over in Handsworth. We've got all the other issues that have gone on this week. We've got the trial of those charged with the murder of Keon Lincoln. And we don't forget the love and support that we offer to the family of D. John Reed. But also as well, some true champions of our community has been laid to rest this week, such as Michelle Hemmings, following her lung transplant. She decided and she did an effective job of giving back. But each and every one of us has a purpose in life, and God has called us home with. And ironically, in a close proximity to her dying, also as well, we've got Michael Willis, who also championed the cause. And Tuesday the 16th of November at 11 a.m. will be his funeral at the New Testament Church of God in Handsworth. And he will be interred at Sutton Newell Cemetery in Sutton Coalfield. There are many others who have lost their life. Be it, some have lost their lives as a result of criminality, violence on our streets. People have had life-changing injuries, for example. And what we must do is we must not lose sight of the collective responsibility that we all have when these things happen. We must not lose sight also of, whilst many of us want to celebrate and being with the in crowd, someone's got to be getting on with things. Because clearly these storms are here, and these storms of life, they're not just going to go away. They are going to be around for a very, very long time. And as we exit, as we say, exit Black History Month. Yeah, exit it. I'm not a big fan of Black History Month, I must confess. Because as far as I'm concerned, our history, our collective history is every single day of the week. And, you know, one of the things is I find amusing with Black History Month is that a society will tolerate us talking about race and sharing our experiences from the Windrush generation and beyond. But when it comes to November the 1st, we get told again we're playing the race card. Now, that's not good enough. Our history is every day of the week. Our history is a part of British history. We're in the United Kingdom. Doesn't matter where you live in the world. All our histories are just as valuable as the next person's because God created us equally. And we shouldn't be celebrating our history. We should be educating our history in the mainstream history of the world because we are people and we should be counted. And these things do cause issues at times and they cause storms. And these storms need to be weathered. And there are times we're reminded in Psalms 57 and verse 12, and it says, "Be merciful to me, O God, be merciful to me, for in you my soul takes refuge. In the shadow of your wings I will take refuge till the storms of destruction passes by." Many will say, well, you know, normally you go inside. They'll say to me tonight, well, you're inside and it's stormy. But you know something, right? I give God thanks because he has provided me some place where I can seek refuge. Three times I pleaded with the Lord to take it away from me. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore will I boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses so that Christ's power may rest upon me. We're reminded of that in 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9. So we must remember where our foundational cornerstone is. And a foundational cornerstone of weathering the storm is Psalms 46, verse 1. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in times of trouble. We are called to this earth for a specific purpose. With a specific person, even when we don't always know what that purpose is, what we should do is focus on the fact that we are safe with God and that he's in control of our lives. Many may say, well, he's not in control of our lives because look what's happening. Well, you know what? You have to look at it like this. It could and may well be far worse than where we are right now. Have you ever thought that? The only thing can change in life is you. Have the courage to acknowledge your strengths and weaknesses. Take an honest look at yourself and acknowledge that you're not perfect and work on what you can. And this goes out to everybody. This goes out to the perpetrators. This goes out to people in every single walk of life. This goes out to families. Let us take a look at ourselves and see what we can do better to make things better for each and every one. Remember, the first step on the journey to change must be within. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, when we feel as though we're alone in the eye of the storm, let us remember that you are with us and you are with us always. Father, with you, we know we can weather anything. We know, Father, that you're not just acting, Father, as an umbrella. You're not just acting as a raincoat. You're not acting as a windbreaker. You're not acting, Father, as a light. You are acting as our protection. You are our shield. You are our strength. And you provide us the guidance that we need to continue on the journey that we need to take. Father, thank you for being there with us, Father. Thank you for being there, Father God, for no matter how heavy the burden is, we give you the praise, the honor, and the glory, Father God. Father, we just want to thank you today for what you are doing for us and what, Father God, you will be doing for us. Father, we just ask that you continue, your blessings continue upon us. Father, when there are doubts, we know, Father, that you are there for us. Father, there are times when we struggle to find a way out under the dark clouds. But Father God, we know despite at times when we feel that everything is going wrong, you will give us greater courage to work towards making things better. Father, we leave our future in your hands right now. Father, in the confidence that you will protect us from harm and you will give us your peace and presence of mind by keeping our eyes open whilst your light is shining upon each and every one of us. Bless us all, we pray. Guide and protect us throughout the week. We give you thanks in the mighty name of Jesus as we say amen. So, despite the storms that are there, God will protect us. And one of the things we've got to do is just remember, He is our strength in times of trouble, in times of need. All we've got to do, reach out to the Lord. God will guide us. He'll see us through. So until next week, Sunday, when we shine a light, same time, same place, join us. But when you join us to shine a light, you can join us to watch. But whilst you're watching, light a candle, light a little tea light. Just meditate and say a prayer. Because together, our prayers are even stronger. And let us do the right thing together. Because together, we can make that all-important difference. Together, we can bring the changes that we need to bring. And together, we will conquer the dark forces that are attacking our streets. The dark forces that overtake people to commit these acts of violence. But tonight, let the storm and let the rain wash away what needs to be washed away. So tomorrow yet again we start afresh. Ready to battle on with the elements of life that may be thrown at each and every one of us. So until next Sunday, 8:30 when we shine a light. God bless you and have a wonderful week in the Lord. Have a good evening.